when we'll hear another talk, actually, which is known as Why Bush Will Lose by Mark Hertzgard tonight at 8 o'clock, a presentation from the Ruth Group. And we recorded this, I believe, just this past week as well. 1-800-439-5732. Ask for George Lakoff. Ask for KPFA. Keep us on the air and keep this radio station growing and right where it is at 94.1 FM. KPFA, KPFB, Berkeley, KFCF, Fresno. After this message, we'll continue with About Health, but please keep calling and supporting KPFA. Help us make this fund drive a success and make sure that KPFA continues to be on the air and right where it should be at 94.1 FM as a listener-supported community radio station. We can only do this with your help. We're urging you to give us a call, 1-800-439-5732. Up next, Dr. Michael Lenore with About Health, but please keep calling and support Dr. Lenore's work as well as all of you listeners who support his program. Please, coming up next.
KPFA is looking for a new general manager. Do you know someone who knows what the Pacifica mission sounds like? Who has a step-by-step plan of how to fulfill it? A desire to pick up the pieces of a puzzle that includes a community of paid and unpaid staff, volunteers, listeners, unserved and underrepresented communities? We're seeking a level-headed person with broadcast experience who's a fearless, visionary leader and a great communicator. We want a committed general manager with a sense of humor who's also a good listener. If you know this person or are this person, go to our website, www.kpfa.org, for the job announcement or call 510-848-6767, extension 200. The deadline for applications is Friday, May 28th. KPFA is an equal opportunity, affirmative action employer committed to a diverse workplace. Women, people of color, ethnic minorities, and people with disabilities are strongly encouraged to apply. That's www.kpfa.org.
This is KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno. It's 201. Stay tuned for About Health with host Dr. Michael Lenore.
Welcome to today's edition of About Health. I'm your host, Dr. Mike Lenore. Glad to be back with you again this week talking about issues in health. Programs About Health, KPFA, KPFB, KFCF in Fresno. Today, a special guest returned to us. We always try to get the popular people back for the pledge period, and I think most of you know from listening to KPFA's, and I certainly know that this is our pledge period, so at any time during our program, you want to show your support, you can't wait until the final phase when we really kind of give you what we have to give in response to your pledge. The number is 848-5732 and the 510 area code 848-5732. All right, well, I'd like to welcome back Dr. Harold Kristal and James Haig. Dr. Kristal, a dentist with interest in metabolic disease. James Haig, a nutritional counselor. They've been with us before. The book, The Nutrition Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Type. This is a book that talks about the role of diet and illness and wellness. And so we want you to stay with us for the full hour. As always, if you want to join us, in 510 area code is 848-4425. We don't have the full program today because of our pledge period, so you might want to get on the lines, 848-4425. Welcome back. I mean, I don't know whether you realize it this, but you've made a special list here at KPFA. We only invite back during the pledge period, people we know are going to be successful with our audience. So we want you to know that you are in our Hall of Fame. So thank you for coming once again.
We're honored.
All right, tell us a little bit about your, we talk to nutritionists almost every other week, or at least in relationship, nutrition in relationship to another number of other topics. What distinguishes your work from other nutritional programs?
Well, metabolic typing is a system of nutritional analysis that helps to make sense out of all the conflicting nutritional information out there. Because one of the problems that people have is there's so many conflicting views on diet and nutrition. It's almost as controversial as religion or politics. But it's hard to make sense for the average consumer out of it all and know where to go. So the program that Dr. Kristal has devised and that I work with him has to do with finding a way to identify what foods work best for your particular metabolism.
Dr. Kristal, how did you get interested in this work?
Well, I started off many years ago when I graduated from the University of Minnesota with Adele Davis. She was a wonderful female nutritionist at the time, and she really lit my interest in nutrition, and working with her, I developed this interest in nutrition. And then after that, every week that I practiced as a dentist, I worked a day and a half as a nutritionist, 3.5 days as a dentist. So when I retired as a dentist, I went into nutrition full time. And actually, I went into developing a program of blood pH. And the blood pH is a very important factor. We all know what urine pH is and saliva pH is, but blood pH is a new venture. It's a new protocol. And we devise a way that one can easily find out what blood pH is in individuals.
Introduce our audience to the whole concept of metabolic typing and what metabolic types refer to.
Well, the metabolic types refer to the different ways in which your body produces and processes energy. And our work is really based on an observation that out of all of the various physiological systems in the body, there seem to be two primary ones that control or govern the metabolism. One of these systems is the oxidative system. And this is the process in the body that converts nutrients into energy. And this happens inside pretty much all the cells of the body with oxygen as a cofactor. And depending on how quickly or how slowly somebody converts nutrients into energy, we would type them as either a fast or a slow oxidizer. And the other system is the autonomic system, which is named after the part of the nervous system that typically, though not always, operates outside of our conscious control. And it regulates all the routine bodily processes that keep us ticking from moment to moment. So if somebody falls into this category, where this is the more dominant system in their particular metabolism, then we would type them according to which of the two branches or divisions of that system is most active in them. One of these branches is the sympathetic branch, which is the part of the nervous system that's more dynamic. It sort of deals with the outside world. It's where the stress response is handled. And the other system is the parasympathetic, which is more the low-key branch, deals with things like sleep, relaxation, digestion, elimination. So first of all, through our testing procedure, which takes about 2.5 hours, we're trying to determine which of these two dominant systems, as we call them, is most active in you, the oxidative or energy-generating system or the autonomic or energy-regulating system, and then to further narrow it down to which subtype within that dominant system best characterizes you.
So you can either be one of four types, oxidative fast, oxidative slow, autonomic, sympathetic, autonomic, and asympathetic.
Exactly.
So there are four basic types. How do you define these types, and what does it all mean clinically?
Well, it's important to understand what metabolic type 1 is. I like to characterize this way. If I would get everyone in the listening audience 500 milligrams of calcium, it would cause half of you, your blood, to become more acid. The other half, it would cause your blood to become more alkaline. Now, this is new information. This is not known. But this happens because of our metabolic types. People that are sympathetic or fast oxidizers have acid blood. People that are slow or parasympathetics have alkaline blood. I'd like to give you an example why it's so important. I had this patient come in to me, and she had a lumpectomy. She had radiation and chemotherapy, and she had that done a year and a half ago. She went back to her oncologist, and she found that she had a recurrence of this cancerous condition, and they told her she would have to have the same thing all over again, lumpectomy, radiation, chemotherapy. She did want to go through that. She came to our office. We measured her out, and I found out that she had very alkaline blood. Her blood was so alkaline, there was no way she could utilize or assimilate any of her trace nutrients. We simply balanced her blood. We got our blood to be more acidic. And after we did that, 3 months later, she went back to the oncologist, and she had a remission. She no longer had cancer of her breast. That woman was 68 years old when she came to my office. She's 80 years old today and never had a recurrence of cancer, and we felt it was primarily because we got her alkaline blood more neutralized.
Now, we have to recognize that's a fairly rare kind of an occurrence. And, obviously people who have recurrences can have spontaneous remissions. And so unless you have a whole collection of those, there are more common problems that you deal with than that. Give us some examples of the day-to-day stuff that people can kind of understand and hang their hat on.
Sure. Well, the most common things we deal with are weight issues, energy issues, and digestion issues. I would say those are sort of the bread and butter of our practice. The point that Dr. Kristal was trying to make is that we're practicing nutrition, not medicine. So we're not diagnosing, curing, treating diseases. But what we are doing is finding out what way the metabolism works most fundamentally, and then addressing it nutritionally through diet and also supplements as needed. Because the basic understanding here is that if you can get the basic metabolism, which is the way you produce and process energy, working properly, then that the body will be given the right tools, so to speak, to be able to deal more effectively with any particular health challenge it's facing.
The book is The Nutrition Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Type. The guest, Dr. Harold Kristal, and James Haig, who's a nutritional counselor. If you want to join us at any point in our program, the number is 510-848-4425. That's 848-4425. Are any of these four classifications associated with any particular clinical type? I mean, can you associate, say, an oxidative fast metabolizer with someone who is busy or have certain kinds of illnesses? Do certain types have certain kinds of problems?
Basically, any member of each of these four types can have a whole range of problems. And pretty much any problem can occur in any type, but there are certain patterns that we see. So, for instance, we work a lot with people who are either diabetic or pre-diabetic. There's one major problem in our country is blood sugar regulation, and that's connected with weight problems or obesity and the way people tend to eat. In our experience, roughly 80% of the people that we've seen who are actually diabetic or on the verge of diabetic are what we call the group 2 types, usually fast oxidizers or parasympathetics. And a similar proportion of people that we see who have cancer are actually the group 1 types, either sympathetics or slow oxidizers. Now, that's not cast in stone, and it's just our own particular population group we happen to be working with. But bottom line is that all these things can be impacted by nutrition. So if we can intervene in a way to point people at the foods that we feel work best for them, we are going to help to prevent these things from happening in the first place, which is the most important thing to do, or if they are starting to happen, to try to curtail the rate at which these diseases take over the metabolism.
So unlike where most practitioners think about intervening after the problem develops, yours is more kind of a screening issue and then developing for that individual particular type of diet based upon that type, which ultimately leads to better quality of health. Is that correct?
I think that's very fair, yeah. I mean, the medical system in this country is primarily a disease management system, and I think you're a medical doctor. I think you probably agree with me on that. The role of nutrition is more to help people to get healthy and stay that way. And the more we can put the focus on health in the first place in a truly preventative way, we're going to prevent the diseases that are running rampant in this society.
Can you tell us a little bit about what an evaluation would look like, Dr. Kristal, for someone who came to see you just for kind of a wellness evaluation?
I see. The evaluation is done in many steps. We have a person or a patient come in on a fasting. They have to be on a fast for at least 12 hours. Then we check their urine and saliva pH. We also do their blood pressures and a number of physical testings. And then we do their glucose tolerance tests on a fast. Then after that, we give them a challenge drink. We want to see what effect this challenge drink does to the patient's blood sugars, their pulse, their blood pressure, etc., and if it changes the pH of their urine or saliva. From all these things, we can extrapolate certain factors that we can determine the metabolic type.
All right, once the type is determined, then what happens?
Then we recommend a certain dietary protocol to the person and usually a few supplements, and we spend quite a bit of time going over this with the individual and tailoring it to their particular needs.
All right, well, give us an example of some of the things that are there certain kinds of diets that appeal to certain any one of these groups? I mean, does, say, a fast oxidizer, sympathetic, need a special kind of diet? Is that kind of the way it works? Or do you have to do a little more detailed evaluation to determine that?
Well, with the two oxidative types, the fast and slow oxidizers, we're trying to either speed up their oxidative rate, the rate at which they convert nutrients into energy, in the case of a slow oxidizer, and the way to do that is to give them a diet focused more around complex carbohydrates with the leaner proteins. Whereas with the fast oxidizers, who tend to burn up carbohydrates too quickly, we're giving them more proteins and fats and less of the complex carbohydrates in order to slow down the rate at which they're otherwise overly quickly burning up the carbohydrates. And then with the two autonomic types, you can think of the metaphor of a seesaw. If, say, somebody is a sympathetic type, to the degree they're more sympathetic, they're proportionately less parasympathetic. So we're giving them foods to bring up the other side of the equation so that they're more, they reach a more dynamic equilibrium.
What is as far as the diets are concerned, what are you able to define from your patient population that you makes you feel that they're healthier and better organized or, from a physiologic perspective than other people who are involved in other types of diets?
Well, I must go back to the work of Dr. George Watson. He was a full professor at the University of Southern California. It was his observation that whenever his patients became too acid or too alkaline, that is in his blood, their blood pH became too acid or too alkaline, their disease system worsened. When he brought them into balance, he found out that disease systems improved. So it really doesn't make any difference what disease system one has, but if one will balance their blood pH, it's certainly going to help them actually absorb, utilize their trace nutrients, which will automatically offer them a better health system.
The other thing is, if I can just interject, when we see the client for the second time, we're able to get both a subjective report from them as to how they're doing, and also we retest them, and we're looking at all these various objective markers that we look at, the urine and saliva pH, the breath rate, the pulses, the blood pressure, the blood sugar, etc. And from these, we're able to actually objectively notice changes in people.
One of the things that comes to mind is if you know what type, you go through this evaluation, you know what type of metabolic tracing you have, how can you use that information to interface with just the traditional healthcare system? I mean, say you've got a number of different options for care for a particular problem, diabetes you mentioned, cancer you mentioned. How would you use this information to talk to your doctor, to talk to your oncologist, in a way that would be that would perhaps either tailor or alter your therapy?
That's a good question, because there's always a tricky area when a patient is bringing some information to a doctor that didn't come from the doctor. So it's kind of somewhat a politically charged issue sometimes. So I'm not sure if I have any easy answer to that, but certainly the client is welcome to refer the doctor to our website or even have them call us if they want more information on this. But for instance, with the management of diabetes, the traditional way of managing it has tended to be to put people on a high-protein diet, but much research over the last years has pointed in just the opposite direction, that you need, did I say a high-carbohydrate diet? That's what I meant to say. I misspoke. But in fact, a lot of the information is now pointing towards needing a lower-carbohydrate diet to control the insulin response. And, these are the types of things where we can be helpful with people, at pointing them in directions that work with their metabolism rather than against them.
848-4425 is our number, the 510 area code. If you have interest in nutrition, your own metabolic typing, if you've got a disease management issue and you want to discuss that in relationship to nutritional typing, we have Sir Dr. Harold Kristal here, Dr. James Craig, who's a nutritional counselor. The book, The Nutrition Solution, 848-4425. Is our number. When we talk about nutritional typing, we talk about some of the things that you've done. What are some of your opinions on the prevailing dialogue in this country about the various types of diets? The Atkins diet, the low-carb diet. I mean, there are all these various diets, and it would seem to me that someone who has a certain type of typing, if they're not effective in defining what that typing is, can get into a lot of trouble.
Yes, that's a very confusing issue, because usually a person that reads the book, the last book they read is the type of nutritional counseling they will follow, and if it has to be an Atkins type diet, that's a heavy protein, heavy fat, low carbohydrate, if he's metabolically type for that, he'll do well. However, if he is not metabolic type for that, say he's a slow or a sympathetic, that type of diet would go against him. However, if he were a fast or a parasympathetic, that would be the proper diet for him. Same thing with the Pritikin diet or the Ornish diet. They're highly vegetarian diets. They would do well with the sympathetics and the slows. They would do very poorly with the parasympathetics and the fast. I might also add that in metabolic nutrition, we don't look at the disease. We look at the person with the disease. Why does that person harbor this disease? It's because of certain imbalances they have metabolically. And we try to balance out these metabolic imbalances.
Is it more important to control your weight or to control your pH?
Well, often the two will travel together. That's a very good question. The pH is one of the markers we use. It's perhaps the single most important one, but it's only one of the markers we use. So usually you'll find that as you control the pH, the weight will start to normalize. As you control the weight, the pH will start to normalize. So they kind of work together symbiotically.
Now, I assume in your book you give people the tools that they need to define in some way where they might fit and what they might do.
Yes and no. I mean, the book outlines metabolic typing. It has a lot of information about it. Both theoretical and practical. It talks about the various diets we recommend and so forth, and there is a short questionnaire in the book. But as we clearly state in the book, a questionnaire alone is not very reliable because it's purely subjective information. So we do strongly encourage people, whenever possible, to come to our metabolic nutrition clinic in San Rafael. And if that's not possible, we also have a self-test kit that people can use if they live too far away. And we do work with people all around the country and to some degree all around the world with that.
Give us a short example of some of the questions that are on the questionnaire that people might ask themselves to at least begin the process.
Questions like whether or not you get hungry between meals. It's more characteristic of what we call the group 2 types, the fast oxidizers and the parasympathetics, that they'll tend to need to eat regularly and they might need to eat between meals, whereas the group 1 people are often people who can roll out of bed, gnaw on the edge of an orange or a bagel and zoom off to work and not think about food until 1 or 2 in the afternoon.
I know what group I'm in almost. Go ahead.
But for a fast oxidizer like myself, that would be a form of cruel and unusual punishment. So, you know, that's the type of question that we ask people.
All right, 848-4425 is our number. The program's about health. The book, The Nutrition Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Type. Dr. Harold Kristal is our guest. Mr. James Haig is our guest. Let's go to Stephania in Emeryville. You're on About Health.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. I'm curious. I live in the Hayward area. And are there any referrals for the East Bay that you can give me? Or the other thing is, what about your self-test kit that you just mentioned?
Well, if you're in the Bay Area at all, we would urge you to come to our clinic, which is in San Rafael. To the best of my knowledge, there's no one in your area doing metabolic typing. We are located in San Rafael. The phone number there is 415-257-3099.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Okay, take care.
Bye. All right, let's go to Camille in Oakland. You're on About Health.
Hey, how you doing?
How you doing?
Hey, thank you for the show.
Thank you.
I'm a diabetic, and been a diabetic now for about maybe 15 years, and I'm experiencing a new thing, ear infection. Never had that before, and I'm taking antibiotics for it, amoxicillin, and I'm just wondering, what else can I do in addition to taking my the antibiotics? And how long does it take to clear ear infection? Two questions.
Right. Remember, we're not medical practitioners,
okay.
So I'd be reluctant to make any comment about, you know, a situation that requires a prescription. But, you know, the main way we look at this is we would try to, by balancing your metabolism, to boost your immune system.
Okay.
Because when somebody's dealing with, you know, chronic disease like diabetes,
right,
all kinds of, it affects every system in the body. It affects the immune system, the endocrine system, obviously, the nervous system, and all kinds of, the vascular system. And the central thing that needs to be done is to try to bring the blood sugars and the insulin levels under control.
Okay.
And based on that, the body will be able to more correct itself.
Okay.
Doctor, you want to say anything about that? Or?
No, I think, James, I said it very well.
Well, I want to would you talk about one of the other things that your book describes are other aspects of nutrition. Certainly there are many people who feel that that one of the things that's constantly ignored by every system is dental health. I mean, even people who get it won't go get it because of the potential. I know they got this painless dentistry thing going, but I don't think that hasn't impressed me much just yet. But you have a section in your book on dental toxicity. Doc, can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes, I've been a dentist for 50 years, and the first 30 years of my practice, I put a lot of mercury and nickel in people's mouths. The last 20 years of my practice, I took those all out. That was my practice. I'm a biological dentist. I believe strictly that the body can handle certain materials, it can handle certain materials. And you have to know what materials that your body can handle, because it creates a lot of toxic waste when the body, if you are not getting the proper metal and so forth. So I do have about 20 pages on biological dentistry in the book, and we describe what I just talked about in depth.
But, you know, there have been a number of studies looking at, you know, there, obviously when you talk about dental issues, it becomes not only a medical but political issue. There's a political issue of fluoride. There's a political issue of putting amalgams and various chemicals in people's mouths and how that relates to various kinds of diseases. But to my knowledge, there have been very little substantiation for the fact that these materials actually cause many of the diseases with which they are associated.
Well, I had the privilege of doing a lot of immune panels on my patients, and the way I did that is I found out what their basic immune panel was, and then I took out the mercury fillings. I tested them 6 months later just to see the effect of the immune system, the T lymphocytes, etc. And I found invariably, after you got the toxic mercury fillings out of the mouth, that the whole immune system went much higher. And I did this on 29 patients, and this has been published. It's been published primarily in alternative medical journals and dental journals, but it was not published in the traditional medical journals.
Now, just to show my naivete, I mean, when I'm at the dentist, I'm really concentrating on my own personal survival. Are they still using mercury in fillings?
Unfortunately, they are, but to a much lesser extent. They now use composite fillings or some ceramics, which are much kinder to people's health.
All right, 848-4425. We're talking about metabolic typing. If you've got questions about your type or how to deal with it, how it relates to wellness, how it relates to illness, 848-4425. Is a number. Let's go to Mike. You're on About Health.
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah, hi. Good afternoon, gentlemen. My question is kind of nutritionally related to prostate cancer, and I seem to have a hard time getting agreement from doctors on the therapeutic dose of selenium that seems to prevent prostate cancer, and either you get it from food or from nutritional supplements. Wondering if you have any thoughts on that.
Yes, I have very strong doubts on how much selenium one should take, but they should not only take selenium, but there's a multitude of nutrients that they should take. But I would say that the average person who has prostate cancer should take at least 200 micrograms daily.
Micrograms or milligrams?
Micrograms.
Oh, okay.
And what about those people who are trying to use selenium as a preventive aid, taking it prophylactically to prevent prostate cancer?
I think that's very excellent, as long as they keep it at a low dose.
What dose would that be?
Well, between 200. I think you could go up to 400 micrograms, just so you don't exceed 400 micrograms. The lethal dose of selenium has to be 1,000 micrograms. You can get into problems from a disease standpoint if you take more than 1,000 micrograms. So I like to keep everybody under 400 micrograms on a daily basis.
But you would need to take that 1,000 microgram dose for a prolonged period of time. Selenium in and of itself, at the doses we're talking about, is very safe. And not only that, it's extremely well studied as being highly protective against cancer, both prostate cancer and other forms of cancer as well.
All right, 848-4425 is the number, the 510 area code. We're KPFA, KPFB, KFCF in Fresno. Let's go back to Stephania in Emeryville. Hello? All right. Is it Lisa? No, I think Lisa from San Jose is next. Lisa, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay.
I was wondering if the metabolic testing is recommended for people with hypothyroidism to help them sort that issue out a little bit.
Yes, metabolic typing is good for anybody because it balances out the blood pH. Now, a hyper or hypothyroidism, we know that almost 40% of the population is hypothyroid. And so there are many tests you can do. You do the T3, T4 update and the TSH test. There's also other tests that you can do which are more sophisticated. We rather do the more sophisticated testing on the thyroid because we feel the TSH has too much margin of error.
The other thing about thyroid situations is that often they're related to adrenal situations because the endocrine system works as sort of like a symphony orchestra, and if one part of it is out of tune, it tends to throw the other parts out. So sometimes a thyroid problem is primarily a thyroid problem, but sometimes it's a reflective problem with the adrenal glands. But either way, working through nutrition, we can help to at least give the body the right elements it needs to support the proper functioning of the metabolism, so it'll be better equipped to deal with these things. Doesn't mean they're going to go away overnight or you can just toss your medicines out of the window, but it does mean that we're giving you the tools to deal with it more effectively.
You know, go ahead, please go ahead.
Okay. Would the metabolic testing help distinguish if it was only a thyroid problem?
Well, remember, we're not diagnosing disease. So what we're really doing is trying to find out what type of metabolism you have and address you on that level. So, no, in and of itself, our testing will not offer you any sort of diagnostic tool. But we do have various ways of assessing the relative health of different organ systems in the body during our testing protocol.
All right, thank you for that question. You know, there are certain conditions in medicine that are very difficult to manage. You know, certainly for certain forms of allergy, chronic fatigue syndrome, polymyositis. These are conditions that that clearly have symptoms that are predictable, but that the medical traditional medicine has a great deal of difficulty dealing with. How does metabolic typing, have you found that metabolic typing helps people to be better able to both understand and manage these kinds of conditions?
Well, that's a good question. There are many conditions that could be called subclinical, meaning that they don't technically qualify for a disease diagnosis. And usually these are the conditions that modern medicine is least equipped to address effectively. And this is precisely where the work of people like ourselves come in. Because what we're doing is we're looking at the foundation of how the body works. We're not looking at symptomology, although we certainly listen to the symptoms and we take note of what symptoms you have. But we're primarily trying to find out how does your body work most fundamentally at the level of the production and processing of energy? And are you eating foods that are in alignment with the way your metabolism works? And then based on that, we can point you in the right direction nutritionally. Because food, I mean, a lot of us think of food as just either something to fill us up or something to give us pleasure, both of which it does. But we actually have a hormonal response to food. Everything that we put in the body responds to in certain ways. And there used to be this expression in the computer business about 20 years ago, garbage in, garbage out. Well, it's kind of the same with nutrition. If you put garbage foods into your body, which unfortunately most Americans are doing, you can expect to get garbage results, which show up as the chronic, subclinical, degenerative diseases that we see in this country. So, yes, our work is a way to try to bring people back into alignment so that they can more effectively deal with these subclinical conditions that are hard to pinpoint medically.
Yes, I might mention that alternative medicine has come up with a tremendous amount of new supplements to deal with the allergy systems of the body. And we have to keep in mind that nutrition doubles in knowledge every 3 years. So nutrition has come a long ways, and every 3 years it doubles in knowledge. And the knowledge we have on these various allergies are just immense. We have so many wonderful supplements can be used to allay allergies and some of these other systems.
Before we get real excited about nutritional typing, how much does an evaluation cost, and does insurance ever pay for those evaluations?
We would love for insurance to pay for it, but usually insurance will only pay for acute medical care, not for nutritional counseling, unless it is specifically prescribed by your doctor. Occasionally, some people can get it in that way. The cost of a visit, which takes 2.5 hours approximately in our office and usually involves the attention of three different nutritionists, runs $210 plus whatever supplements we recommend on top of that.
Sounds reasonable. What about Pilar in San Francisco? You've got a question.
Yeah, it was pretty well answered, I suppose, by the last information. But my boyfriend has a severe asthma that's brought on by allergies to pets. And he's tried a lot of the different medical approaches, and I'm more inclined to try to get him interested in some alternatives. So I was just going to ask you what kind of successes you've had in that area.
Well, we've had excellent success with one of our asthmatics and some of our allergies that actually preempted the asthmatic attacks. Yes, there are wonderful supplements, and the best thing one can do whenever they're in that situation is get metabolically balanced so they have their whole immune system working for them. They're assimilating and utilizing all their trace nutrients and macronutrients. That's the first thing, and then we can address with certain supplements that will address the asthmatic and the allergenic situations that that your boyfriend does have.
And with an allergy, basically the immune system is on overdrive. It's reacting inappropriately to substances that are actually representing no threat to it. So it's important to try to calm the immune system down. And if a person is eating foods that are wrong for their metabolism, it will exacerbate this immune imbalance.
Once again, we're talking about the Nutrition Solution, a guide to your metabolic type. 848-4425 is our number in the 510 area code. Remember, we have a shortened program today because we have to ask for your support for our program and for KPFA. But let's take the time to go to Petaluma and talk to Ron. You're on About Health.
Hello?
Yeah, it's your turn.
Okay, hi. Yeah, my question is this. My father was normal. My mother was diabetic. And it seems to me during the course of my life I have a tendency to gain weight if I'm inactive, but I always have myself checked out every 6 months to a year, and you know I'm come up normal. My question is, would the fact that you have one parent say that diabetic have something to do with your metabolism, even though you're not diabetic yourself?
There's often a genetic component with diabetes, but it's important to make a crucial point here. With the interest in the Human Genome Project and so forth, which is fascinating, a fascinating area of exploration, there's a tendency to reduce everything down to genes. So if somebody has a genetic predisposition to a disease or a genetic weakness in a certain area, whilst it means they might have to be more careful or more diligent than somebody else, it by no means guarantees that they're going to get that disease, unless it's an outright genetically transmitted disease like, I can't think of anything off the top of my head, a neurological disease, for instance. But in the case of diabetes, there is a huge gap between what is called the genotype or the genetic potential and the phenotype, which is the expression of that genetic potential. And in between those two polarities, there comes your diet, your lifestyle, everything about how you live your life. And those things will control whether or not the genotype will manifest as the phenotype of diabetes. By no means does it have to do so. And also, there are many, many people in this country who have a problem with diabetes who don't have any genetic disposition towards it. It's just that it's encouraged by the types of foods that people have grown up eating. So certainly, controlling the weight and so forth and finding out what foods are right for your particular metabolism will go a long way to short-circuiting problems like diabetes. And that's a major thrust of what our work is about.
Are you going to say anything, Doctor? Was it?
No, diabetes we see quite a bit of, and there are many aspects of diabetes. We're finding in our practice that we find many people that come in with a high blood sugar are not diabetics, but their blood sugar has raised simply because of hormonal issues. In other words, certain hormones or five hormones in the body which will raise the blood sugar. And this usually happens at night, so when we measure you the first thing in the morning, they might come in with a high fasting sugar. And a lot, automatically, these people are diagnosed as diabetics, and they're not diabetics. I have four such patients in my practice right now that come in with a fasting blood sugar of over 130, and these are not diabetics. It's just the dawn effect, the fact that the hormone system has elevated their blood sugars.
The other side of that, if I can just quickly add, though, is that if there is a weight control issue for you, then it's definitely important that you try to take care of that, because excess weight tends to promote insulin resistance, which is the phenomenon that is the that sets the stage for adult onset diabetes.
All right, let's go to Oakland and talk to Pat. You're on About Health.
Hi. Hi, Dr. Lenore.
Hi.
I'm one of your patients.
Hope successfully treated.
Oh, listen, remember me? I'm the one who got my sense of smell back because of getting allergy shots.
Oh, thanks.
I was going to ask the question about cost, and you did that for me, but in the wait time, I've come up with two questions, and I'll take my answers off the air. The first one is, as someone who had had chronic sinus problems for over 10 years, two polypectomies, and multiple courses of antibiotics, I mean, more than is probably normal and healthy. I'm curious as to whether through testing and what you might recommend for me, I can rebuild my immune system and strengthen my immune system for the rest of my life. And my second question is whether or not your guests are familiar with Eat Right for Your Blood Type system and the presence of lectins in foods that are ingested, and whether or not they put any store in that. And again, I'll take my answer off the air. Thank you.
Yeah, that's a good question. There are a lot of diets out there very similar that look at various aspects of blood chemistries. She said, how is yours so different?
Yeah, I'll answer that first and then try to get... Well, let me just quickly say about your first question. That's a complicated question, and truthfully, we'd really need to sit down with you and talk with you to really get a sense on how to get a handle on that. And nor are we claiming that we can, you know, we're not trying to cure diseases per se. We're simply trying to give you the tools to make your body work better to help it to control disease. But in terms of the Eat Right for Your Blood Type system, it made a very important contribution in that most diet regimes out there are universally recommended to all readers. So there will be one program. So you all eat the Atkins diet, or you all eat a high carbohydrate diet, or whatever it happens to be. The Eat Right for Your Blood Type brought in the important point that different people need different kinds of diets. So we highly commend it for that, and it has been very helpful to many people. However, I would say that in practice, it's hanging a whole system off of one metabolic marker, which is your blood type. And in our own work, where we're working with about 8 or 9 markers, none of them are ever completely accurate on their own or reliable on their own. So we don't think that one marker will bear the weight of a whole system. And then in practice, we've only seen about a 50% correspondence between the blood types and the metabolic types.
All right, let's go to Carol in San Francisco. You're on About Health. Carol? All right, let's go to Audrey in Oakland. You're on About Health. It looks like we've lost both. Who do we have on the line?
Me.
Okay, let's. And you are?
Todd.
And you're from Oakland?
Yes.
All right, let's go. What's going on?
I'm here at Ital Calabash, down here on Franklin, having some Ital food, and listening to your radio station. Everybody here in the restaurant has questions for you, but I'll try to make it brief. One question I have is about pH in water. I know that when plants do well, when they have a pH-balanced water, how important is that for humans to have pH-balanced water?
Yes, I will answer that question. pH is very, very important. We like the pH to be as neutral as possible for the water. Most people feel that it should be alkaline or a little on the acid side. Actually, it could be very helpful for moving your blood pH one way or the other if it were slightly alkaline or slightly acid, if it was right for your metabolic type. So, but the best thing you can do is drinking the cleanest water you can get. Don't drink tap water.
And most natural water has a pH of around 7.
All right, we have another caller on the line, but we don't have the name.
This is Lynn in Oakland.
Okay, Lynn.
Yeah, I have a question. You're talking a lot about how to boost the immune system, and I'm wondering about people who have hyperimmune diseases like MS and other autoimmune types of diseases. What do you recommend for them?
That's a tricky question, and of course we're getting into a complicated medical area, which is not our area of expertise. But what I would say is once again, at the risk of sounding like a broken record, even though people don't have records anymore, what we're trying to do with our work is to address the fundamental metabolism. And in so doing, we feel that we're going to help it come into balance. So if a person's out of balance in one direction or if they're out of balance in the other direction, in a sense, it doesn't make a lot of difference because we're trying to bring you back to that balance point, which is more in the middle. So for somebody whose immunity is overactive, obviously, we would hope that by balancing the metabolism that it would help to calm that down.
Yes, I'd like to add just a few little words on that. We look at the T4, T lymphocytes 4 and T lymphocytes 8. Now, T4s are your helper cells. Your T8 cells are the cells, the killer cells. Now, when you have an overactive immune system, your T8s take over. You have more T8s in relationship to your T4. Actually, you want to keep a wonderful balance, if you possibly can, between the T4s and the T8s.
All right. Well, can you give us your office number one more time? We have a phone bank full of calls, but we're going to have to stop in behalf of our station so that we're here next week and the week after when you come back, and perhaps that you'll be willing to take some of these questions once you get back to San Rafael. Can I have your office number, if that's okay?
The office number is 415-257-3099. That's 415-257-3099, and we also have a website, which is the 3 W's, and then blood, and then the letters P as in Peter, H as in Henry, .com, so bloodph.com, and there's also an email address you can contact us through the website.
And so we apologize for those of you who are still on the air. Usually we try to get to all of your questions, but it's now time for us to ask for your support as we have tried to support you. And Mr. Haig has agreed to stay with us to help us to pitch. I guess he's a KPFA fan, and we're glad to have him with us. So we're going to ask you to start to call to support our program. The number is 510-848-5732, 510-848-5732, or 1-800-439-5732. That's 1-800-439-5732. They also have it in parenthesis that it's 100-HEY-KPFA. Now, I can never get that together. I'd rather have the numbers. So I'm going to give you the numbers again and often over the next 15 minutes. So what we're offering is, for your support for KPFA, is the Nutritional Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Typing by James Haig and Harold Kristal. And this book actually represents not only a body of science, but a body of experience over a number of years. Mr. Haig, tell us a little bit about what went into the development of this book.
Well, the book was the brainchild of Dr. Kristal, my metabolic mentor, who's sitting in the studio with us. And the first part deals with his own nutritional odyssey, how he got to the point of getting into metabolic typing. And then it goes into the 3 chapters that talk specifically about what metabolic typing is. And then there's a whole bunch of chapters that go into all kinds of health topics that will be of interest to anybody, things like weight, hormones, cancer, various types of foods, et cetera, et cetera.
Well, Dr. Lenore, this is Ranjita, your producer. I just want to say that a lot of people were calling here asking questions and wanting to get on the air to ask a question to the doctors about the metabolic typing. And so I want to encourage people to call and get the book because it's a great resource for you at home. The number is 510-848-5732, 1-800-439-5732. And we're here at About Health every week to give you so many things dealing with health issues. We've covered from headaches to prostate cancer, nutrition and heart problems. So again, I want to encourage people to call for a $60 donation, 848-5732, 1-800-439-5732.
Yeah, and you know, every week we're here to give you what we call the least expensive second opinion, not the cheapest, but the least expensive second opinion in town. I believe that we're still the only program that allows you to call each week and talk to experts such as Dr. Kristal and Mr. Haig, so that you can get your questions answered directly, giving you the necessary tools to get back into the healthcare system as a more informed consumer. So the number is 848-5732, 1-800-439-5732. For $60, you get the book and you get to support those of us here at KPFA who believe that this is the best station in the area and the best station in the country. And I think we've demonstrated a consistent level of commitment to this community for over 50 years. A original radio, community radio station, and we are the one program, as I've said, in health that allows you to call and talk to experts. So we don't think that $60, especially in these inflationary times, is too much money for a book like this. And I believe, Mr. Haig, in spite of what you and Dr. Kristal have said, that if you pick up the nutrition solution and you read through it, you're going to get a pretty good idea of what type you are, and you might be able to short-circuit the system by adding some things to your diet that you wouldn't do otherwise. Am I wrong about that?
No, you're not wrong. We just feel for a more thorough, in-depth look that it's great to work with a practitioner. But certainly the book is a wealth of information, if I don't mind saying so myself. And it's written, you know, in a reader-friendly style. There's a couple of sections that may be a little heavy going, but you can skip over those and read the rest of it, which is written very clearly. I feel quite honored to be here today because I've been a listener and subscriber to KPFA myself for the last 25 years. And this station is an incredible resource. It's so often that when you have something really good in your surroundings, you just kind of take it for granted. But if you were to go most places in the United States, you're not going to find a station like this. You're not going to find a station where a medical doctor from the local community like Dr. Lenore will take time from his busy practice and come in on a volunteer basis and interview people each week with interesting things that they have to say about health. And you're not going to get a wide spectrum of opinion as you do here. And, you know, this type of information is cutting edge. And a lot of the more corporate media-controlled outlets are not interested in airing this information.
No, there's no question about that. The number here is 510-848-5732, 510-848-5732, or 1-800-439-5732. And I appreciate Mr. Haig's testimony, and we really appreciate people like you and Dr. Kristal, and certainly Dr. Kristal, who's held the line, I'm sure, in Marin under consistent assault as you see the whole area of alternative health evolve and to what seems to be it's always been credible, but recognized as a credible contribution. I know through the years, Doctor, you've faced many a critic in the Marin area, but I have a sense that by looking at your science, that you've held fast and been more than a worthy adversary as we struggle to try to integrate both tradition and non-traditional medicine. Am I right about that?
Oh, you're so right. Anyone that deviates actually too far from the mainstream of medicine or dentistry, they're fraught upon with certain hazardous situations. I believe so strongly in what I was doing, and they went along with me, and I think I have the respect of the medical and dental profession at this point.
And this book is The Nutrition Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Type. It's beautifully written. A lot of science. 848-5732 is the number. $60 for the book and for the opportunity for us to have guests like Dr. Kristal. I consider this my own contribution simply because this is what I want to do, and I think KPFA has offered me opportunities that other radio stations would not. That is to come and do and bring to you the people that we want you to have. We're not worried about what you say to them, how you talk to them, but we are concerned if you are not willing to support us in our effort to remain an independent community radio station. So for $60, you get The Nutritional Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Typing by James Haig and Harold Kristal. And there's some other things in this book. You got a little section here in the back of this book that talks about other aspects of nutrition, which might not have as much to do with the theory. What's that little section all about? There's a section here in the back, and maybe I may have misread it, but it talks about the whole issue of, a potpourri of nutritional information. And this is maybe in conjunction with the diet, but certainly there's information on amino acids, the vitamin C, and the not-so-sweet truth about sugar. That's all kind of a little bonus piece, isn't it?
It's bonus information, and we've got information in there about eggs, about soy. There's a lot of controversy. Soy has been both promoted as the golden calf on the one hand of the natural health food movement, and some people are now saying it's just the opposite. So we try to sort through all this kind of confusion and give you some good straight nutritional information, regardless of your metabolic type.
And there are a lot of references in here and resources, aren't there, as well?
Yes, we have a section of resources, which is very valuable in and of itself.
Dr. Lenore, I just wanted to jump in and thank those people who are on the line. And if you're getting a busy signal, keep trying, because I'm not sure how many phone volunteers we have, but we could always use more as well. If you want to come down to the station and be a volunteer for our phone room, 1929 Martin Luther King Jr. Way. And if you're getting a busy signal, write the number down, 848-5732. 1-800-439-5732, and keep trying.
You know, I have a small dream, not a big dream like Martin Luther King, but a small dream that I can look at this phone bank and see every one of these lines lit up because people are so appreciative of what this station is willing to do and what the station has done for this community. I mean, we come as often as we need to, not as often as we could, to get your support. And for $60 for this really fabulous book of resources, The Nutritional Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Health, Your Metabolic Type, I think that that this is a small price to pay, not only for this book, but certainly for the contribution that KPFA makes to this community and for the contribution Ranjita Geisler makes, who is my producer, who looks around trying to find people that they think that we think you'd be interested in so that you can talk to them every week. And we're pleased and proud that every week we have a full line phones. Every week we have a very, very strong listener base. But our listener base has to be quality as well as strong. And that means picking up that phone, calling and getting this book, or calling to pledge what you can KPFA. The number is 848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. One of the things about, can you give us an example of either Dr. Kristal or Mr. Haig of a person that has benefited, that stands out in your mind, that's benefited from balance in a way that was both clinically measurable and detectable?
Well, one example that comes to mind is there's a middle-aged woman who came to see us a few months ago, been suffering from Crohn's disease. And those of you who are familiar with that, it's a debilitating digestive disorder that's very difficult to treat. And one of the problems with this was you tend to get nauseated every time she ate. And she was having a real hard time keeping food down. She was losing weight. In the wrong sense of the word, losing energy and so forth. But through helping her, through metabolically typing her, pointing at the right foods, giving her certain targeted nutrients, supplements to help support gut function, we've been able to make a substantial difference in her life, and she can now eat without getting nauseous. Her energy is coming back up, and overall she feels an awful lot better.
Now, Kristal, where do you get your supplements from? I mean, do you make them, or are they ordered, or, I mean, are they pretty, are they supplements that if I knew what they were, I could go to the health food store and get them? Well, how does that work?
Basically, we like the quality control, so we manufacture approximately 15 to 16 of our own supplements. But the other supplements that we use the highest quality that we can get.
And I think that's important. I think we've done some programs here looking at even something like vitamin E or supplements. And really, when people go to buy supplements, they don't really understand that a single supplement may be an awful lot of different, may have an awful lot of different qualities. And getting the highest quality supplement certainly is an important piece. Is there anything on the website that suggests that?
Yes, I think there is. There's quite a lot of information on the website about supplements. But Dr. Lenore is very correct. With supplements, cheaper is not always better. And to take one example, fish oil, which is something we use a lot in our practice. You can get bargain basement cheap fish oil, but the chances are it's going to be either rancid or contaminated with mercury or PCBs or dioxins, and you definitely don't want that. So we're very certain that we only pick suppliers that we're certain produce a good quality of supplements.
All right, let's give this number again, 510-848-5732. Those of you who didn't get a chance to get through before can certainly get through now, 848-5732. We don't want you to get tired before we end the 4 or 5 minutes that we have left, or 1-800-439-5732. We have a KPFA goes very, very far north and very far south, and we want to hear from our friends in Sebastopol and in San Jose and all over the area. $60 will get you the book, The Nutritional Solution, A Guide to Your Metabolic Typing, by James Haig and Harold Kristal. A lot of great information. We've already talked about that. But also will support us and support KPFA as we go about doing the kinds of things that we think we need to do in order to give you the kinds of tools you need to deal effectively with the healthcare system. I think I just really admire, I like you, Mr. Haig, but I admire what Dr. Kristal has gone through to be a champion for this kind of work in this area for such a long period of time.
Age before beauty.
Well, that's right. I'm looking around. Both of you are pretty good looking. So it's going to be hard to make that decision. But I do think that what has happened is in my lifetime, and I started working at a very traditional radio station, is to see the ascension of non-traditional, different ways to approach health to the level of being very credible. And so I think that people have to appreciate your investment by calling and pledging to KPFA 848-5732 or 1-800-843-9-5732 or if you're so inclined, 1-800-HEY-KPFA.
And Dr. Lenore, people can pledge online at www.kpfa.org or through electric funds transfer, and it's tax deductible. So those are various, there are many options that you can ask when you call 848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. There's some open lines, so please call us.
And I just wanted to say that although the book is being offered as a premium for those of you who call in at the $60 rate, if funds are a little bit tight and you can't afford that much, you can certainly pledge at any level that you're capable of doing. And so please don't be put off by that amount if that seems a little much to you. Just think of the book, for those of you who can afford it, it's sort of the icing on the cake. What you're really getting here is the pleasure of knowing that you're supporting this extraordinary resource of listener-supported radio. It's a fabulous source of information, of news, of culture, of investigative journalism that's unparalleled on the West Coast.
You know, always KPFA, you know, what people tend to think about KPFA and its political stances have been ahead of the time, but I really believe that our medical program is ahead of other medical programs in very much the same way. Here again, you can always get the sensational in on radio stations and in the news, but very seldom do you get a chance to talk to experienced people like Dr. Kristal and Mr. Haig. I mean, it just does not happen on other radio stations. So 848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732 or on the website, Ranjita, at
www.kpfa.org, or you can call us and do a check or credit card. Everything is well appreciated.
We have gotten to the point at KPFA we can collect money any kind of way you can give. You can bring cash down here, can't you, Ranjita? All right.
You can also...
The Nutritional Solution is the book, A Guide to Your Metabolic Type, $60 pledge, 848-5732. I'd like to thank Dr. Kristal for his work and Mr. Craig for his work as well as his support for KPFA. I'd like to thank Ranjita Geisler once again for selecting good topics.
We want to thank you, Dr. Lenore.
Well, thank you. I need a little thanks every now and then. The Ethnic Health Institute and Out to Bates.